Hey everyone, Tracy at Mystically Divine Tarot. How's everyone today? I hope you're all doing great. Welcome to the channel and welcome to today's Pick a Card reading. Today we will be asking Spirit their thoughts of you. Okay, so what is your person thinking about you at this time? Whatever their thoughts are, could be about your connection, how they're feeling for you, what they're thinking of you, okay? So please remember to like this video and also to subscribe if you haven't already. I greatly appreciate it and I appreciate you all being here. Leave me a comment as well. I love hearing from you guys. All of those things do help my channel, so I am forever grateful for all of you for doing that. And also for all of you who take the time to watch the short ads. That also helps me out as well. So thank you to all of you that do. All right, so today we have three cards pulled from the Sacred Traveler Oracle, okay? And three crystals. Crystal number one is the green fluorite with the view from above card. Okay. For crystal number two is the citrine crystal with rainbow blessings. And for crystal number three, the tiger's eye crystal with surrendering to the journey. Okay. So choose which crystal or card resonates with you most. If you're drawn to more than one, that's perfectly fine. Remember, these are timeless, so whenever they're crossing your path is when the messages are meant for you. And also remember that these are general readings, okay? So not all messages will resonate for everyone. Take what resonates with you and leave the rest behind, okay? So choose which resonates with you most, and I will see you in your reading. If you resonated with crystal number one, the green fluorite crystal, and the view from above card, this will be your reading. Okay, so what I got for you, crystal number one, is they think that you're a big part of their future here, okay? They feel like you're part of the big picture for them, okay? Almost getting like Romeo and Juliet vibes. I feel it's like a deep, because of this imagery here. She's looking out of the balloon, of course, not a balcony, but I was definitely getting that vibe with this card. So I feel like this is some powerful feelings that they have for you, that they, you know, they think loving thoughts about you. They see the future with you. So let's see. Could also be looking at things from a higher perspective as well with the view from above. So looking deeper, really possibly going inward about, you know, what they're feeling and thinking of you here. Okay, let's see. Crystal number one's person. What are their thoughts of crystal number one? So I feel like this is someone who feels like you're a good match. They're wanting to put time and energy. They also think you're a very hard worker. They're wanting to put time and energy into your connection. They could be planning something in their mind here as well. They could be planning something to move toward you. They feel like you invest a lot of time and energy into your life, yourself as well. Very self-loving. Hardworking. What else do they think of crystal number one, please? What else? Crystal number one's person, think of them, please. This is planting the seeds for the future. And again, seeing you in their future, I definitely feel like they are planting some sort of seed here to move toward you as well. Okay, let's see. What else are they thinking, please, about crystal number one? What is crystal number one's person thinking about them? What are their thoughts of them? Well, there we go. Ooh, seven. Two sevens back to back. 7-7. Nice. Very good sign of a lucky time here. Seven of Emotions. So feeling like you have an emotional choice. Yeah, they feel like you choose them. You do in your heart. They feel like you choose them in your heart. So I feel like you really show them a lot of emotion when you can. You really show them how much you care. You could have multiple choices in your life too, or this person may think that you have multiple choices, but they feel like you choose them. So they do feel your love is what I'm feeling there. Let's see what else. You could be just very, you know, kind, compassionate, loving toward them. So they do feel like you choose them, but they might think here, because we're talking about their thoughts, they might think that you have multiple options in your life as well. Let's see what else. So crystal number one, their person's thought. Ooh, look at this. Ooh, yeah, there could be something that needs to end. A sudden shift or change. There could be something that needs to end in one or both of your lives here with the Tower. Endings bring new beginnings. We'll find out what this is with the Clarifier. They may need to end something, or you. Maybe they think that you're ending something. Multiple messages. So I feel like this is multiple people. They feel like you're ending something, but then for some of you, I feel like it's something about you feeling they need to end something. Ace of Emotions. Wow. Yeah, they are in love with you. Okay, their thoughts of you are deep, powerful love, just like I was feeling with that first card. Ace of Emotions is falling in love. They're also thinking about a relationship here with the Ace of Emotions coming through. They're wanting a relationship, so they could be thinking about, this could be what they're working toward as well. I was feeling that here. Planning something. Moving toward that. Interesting. Okay, let's see with the clarifiers. Crystal number one's person's thoughts of them. What are their thoughts? They think you're extremely beautiful, very attracted to you. They have a lot of romantic feelings here with that Ace of Emotions. And they are feeling, I feel like they're thinking about moving toward you here with the Seven of Materials. Keeps coming through. Also feeling, like I said, they admire you. They feel like you're a hard worker. You really take care of your life, things like that. What do we got? Knight of Pentacles. Oh, slowly. Okay. Yeah, so planting seeds for growth slowly. So they might see slow progress. Like they see your growth, okay? And slow is good, right? Because slow means you're being very intentional. So I feel like they see your growth. They see you working really hard. They see you taking care of yourself. And also this could mean that with this coming through that they're working, planting seeds or planning something to come toward you. They could be thinking about coming toward you, but it may be a slow approach. Seven of Emotions. Why the Seven of Emotions? So I feel like they feel like you choose them. They think you choose them. You show them really beautiful, loving emotions. But they might feel like you have other choices in your life as well. This could also be them thinking about an emotional choice they have to make. Because we are in their thoughts, so they might not all be about you, right? I'm sure, like, there's other things that pop. Yeah, oh boy. Yeah, so for some of you, it is you. It could be them as well, because that was just coming through. Yeah, the Tower. So there's a lot of thoughts about whatever this is that has to end in one or both of your lives. There's a lot of thoughts about that. There's an emotional choice to be made on one side or the other. And they're thinking about this a lot. It's heavily on their mind. But yeah, as I was saying, I mean, obviously it's not, every thought isn't going to be about you. And we're in their thoughts here, so There could be some thoughts about their own life that will impact the connection with you as well. Let's see this tower. Can I see what this is? Queen of Wands. Some sort of, yeah, see, for some of you, this is about passion, you know, knowing what you want, being confident in yourself. So I feel like they feel like you're very confident in yourself, but I'm also picking up kind of like that player energy. So what I'm feeling here is this person could think, like I picked up here, that there's multiple options. For some of you, you could be dating multiple people, and because you're so beautiful and attractive and confident, you're attracting a bunch of different people, okay, is what I'm feeling here. And this might just be for some of you, right? Not everyone is dating multiple people at this time, but so they're feeling or thinking like, well, that would have to end, right? Because they're wanting something big with you, Ace of Emotions. They're wanting like a committed relationship here. This is beautiful, deep love. With the slow movement too. It could be that things weren't moving along in this connection, and maybe for some of you, you've moved on to other things. This could be heavily on their mind. If this is about you having multiple choices, and all of these four cards here are about that, so I feel like this is heavily in their thoughts about you. And again, this could be them as well. Like I said, it could be something that they know they have to end because it's in their thoughts, but it would affect this connection. So, Ace of Emotions, like if they were dating multiple people or something like that. Ace of Emotions, please, for crystal number one, their person's thoughts of them. Their person's thoughts of them, please. So definitely very attracted to you. They feel like you're extremely... Ooh, look at the bottom. Empress brought to my attention there. Yeah, they definitely do think you're very beautiful. I was just saying that, and then bottom of the deck came through. So, ooh, look at this. We have the Eight of Pentacles and the Empress. So again, they feel like you're a hard worker. This could even be that they think that you've put a lot of work, time, and energy into them, okay? Into starting something off with them. Maybe you've given this connection a lot of your effort, time, energy, you know? The hard work is paying off. This is really a good sign to come out here, and this one coming out first, which means whatever seeds are being planted, they're thinking that, you know, it'll turn out okay. The hard work will pay off, okay? And they're thinking that you are their Empress. They, you know, again, powerful love with the first card, feeling like that Romeo and Juliet connection, you know, like beautiful love. Yeah, it's just so powerful. With the Ace of Emotions, too, I feel like they feel like you are beautiful and loving, right? Because they feel that from you here with the Seven of Emotions as well. They feel like you choose them because you treat them with love and kindness. And yeah, they see with the Ace of Emotions that you would be someone that they could see themselves loving for the long term. With get the bigger picture in the beginning. All right, so let's see what the oracle for crystal number one, their person's thoughts of them, please. Very attracted to you as well. Physically, I feel powerful, passionate energy with that Queen of Wands, vulnerability. Yeah, so sometimes they feel maybe they need to be more vulnerable with you. You could express things. And then afterwards, they kind of feel bad, is what I'm getting here. they think about it later and they're like, oh, I really should have been more vulnerable with crystal number one. They were opening their heart to me and I kind of shut them down. So for some of you, I feel like this person sometimes shuts you down even though they're having these deep, powerful feelings. Interesting. So, yeah, for some of you, they may still be working on something, but they pull away at some points with that vulnerability card. What are their thoughts of crystal number one? They may think you're vulnerable at times too, right? And you open up and then they feel bad after because they haven't done the same in return is what I'm getting there. Ooh, only time will tell. So yeah, time will tell. We have the Knight of Pentacles out here, right? So it could be a slow moving connection, but time will tell that it is a good connection. They feel like it's a good connection. They think that, you know, this love is pretty powerful. They know how they're feeling. Beautiful card here as well. Sacred union. Honor and treasure your relationship, for it's truly sacred. So they do. They treasure you. Very, very strong love that this person feels. They feel safe with you. Very nice energy. They have very nice energy. What is their person's thoughts of them? Take action. So they want to take action. Yeah, see, I told you they're thinking about that. That they're thinking about that here. Taking some sort of inspired action toward you. Could be that fear there, something there with being vulnerable. Could be blocking this action, but they're wanting to. They're thinking about taking action. And I feel like they are. It could be just very slowly, so it might not even be noticeable almost, you know? Interesting. It's that I want to do this, but I am afraid almost with this card, you know? Yeah, he's really saying a lot, that little kitty cat today. So there could be some sort of fear in this person's mind about something to do with expression, vulnerability. Could be a fear of rejection, but I feel like they feel you choose them. So, well, that might just be for some of you too. Yeah. So that might not be for the people who they feel like you choose them, but the people that maybe you have multiple options, maybe they fear you would choose someone else instead, or All right, what are their thoughts of crystal number one? Thank you. We have, oh wow, a grand symphony. Yeah, they think that this could be big, okay? They really, really do. Music. They think that music, something about music, they might connect with you through music. Maybe they send you music. They might send you music or something like that. If you hear the loud hum kick on in the background, I'm sorry, but it's so, so humid. The air conditioner has to be on or I will melt and not be able to read for you. So please excuse it if it bothers you, but just know it's necessary. But a grand symphony, they definitely feel like this is big, okay? This is a, again, big picture outlook that they think with you. Wow. Yeah, they feel like you're their person. Empress, I mean, Ace of Emotions, Empress, Eight of Pentacles. That's like knowing that the hard work will pay off with you. They definitely feel like you're a hard worker too. They see that you like to take risks as well, that you're a risk taker. You don't let fear hold you back. They look up to you. Yeah, I feel like this person may wish that they could be that way. Like, in other words, maybe they fear taking that risk, you know? And they're looking up to you for that. Like, you're fearless and bold. Very nice. Let's see, what else do they think of crystal number one, please? So they do think about long term with you. They do see that you, well, for some of you, possibly have multiple options in your life to choose from, knowing that that would have to end because they want, like, what I'm feeling here with this Ace of Emotions, they want, like, commitment. They want exclusive, you know? Just you and me. What else, please? There we go. Yeah, look at this. See? They just know. Inner knowing. They just know. Okay, there's a powerful connection going on here. This could be a high-level soulmate or even a twin flame we're talking about. There's that deep inner knowing about it. The intuition is just on point, okay, in this person. They know. See, they know you're their person. And for some of you, they know that you know. They know that you choose them. But for some of you, they might feel like you might choose someone else. Let's see what else. For crystal number one, that person's thoughts of them. My gosh, I love it. We have come to the edge again, which is another fool type of energy, almost like taking risks as well. Come to the edge, starting a new journey. They want to take this new journey with you. They're hoping that you'll want to take it with them, is what I'm feeling here. They think you may, for some of you, because they're kind of like feeling like maybe you'll choose them. And for others, they just know that you're right for each other and that you'll choose them, but something having to come to an end first. Now, this could be in their life as well, remember, right? So it might not even be something that has to end in your life. It could be on their mind that they have to end something before this risk can be taken. Okay? But they definitely are thinking about a new journey with you. New relationship starting, falling in love, being deeply in love, heart overflowing. So this person really overflowing with emotion for you. Yeah. See, they think you're so beautiful, loving, nurturing, kind. You have such a big heart. You share love. Wow. Yeah, they think very highly of you. This person thinks very highly of you. They respect you a lot, too. With the way you present your grace. Very nice. What is crystal number one's person's thoughts of them, please? Yeah, that you're very strong. Yeah, they feel you're extremely intuitive as well. They think you know things, sort of like they do. That's for some of you. I felt like you both knew, right? Yeah, they feel like you know things. And you are very strong. You have a lot of inner strength. Very, very powerful. And you know it. Beautiful. Extremely beautiful. Something about blonde hair here as well coming through. They love your blonde hair. Yeah, they love your blonde hair. So maybe someone just changed their hair color, or for some of you, maybe. I'm also noticing there's a rainbow in this hair as well. Yeah, a symbol of hope. So you've given them hope. This person may have lost hope at some point about love. And you've given them hope. They look to you as very powerful, like you have a lot of inner strength. You're courageous and resilient. You take risks. Yeah, that already came through a couple times here with come to the edge too. I was feeling that risk taking. they like that about you, that you, you know, you're fearless, you know, you're fearless and bold. You do tower again. Wow, this is a big focus here. Whatever this is, it could even be for both of you. Man, this energy coming through so much. So I definitely feel like maybe this is for both of you. Something having to end in both of your lives. Because it was coming through, it could be either or. Because if they're going through something that's coming to an end, of course that's going to be on their mind. Especially if it's something that will prevent this connection from forward movement. So I feel like that's on their mind very heavily. But I also feel like this could be for both of you. And that might just be for some of you as well, right? But both of you having to take care of something in your lives. Let me get some message cards from them, please. Their thoughts of crystal number one. Oh, what would they like to say? Get some of their thoughts right here. What would they like to say to crystal number one? What are their thoughts? We got two. Please don't give up on our love. Yeah, wow. And wow, look at that, together. I'm going to put them this way. It's kind of like one whole sentence. Please don't give up on our love. Our love is a love of a lifetime. Okay, so this person feels it very deeply. They're hoping if you are possibly moving on from the connection, they may be hoping that you're not, okay? Or if you have multiple options, they might be hoping here that you choose them, okay? So they're thinking a lot about that as well, being your choice. For some of you, I do feel for sure they do know, they have that inner knowing that you choose them, but there's something in one or both of your lives that could be standing in the way of making change. What else? I'm sorry. Wow. So they think they hurt you in some way, or they did something they need to apologize for. What else are they thinking? I still have healing to do. So they are working through something for some of you, okay? I feel like that come through just to clarify that for some of you it is them going through something, okay? It could be both of you, like I said, but ooh. Please appreciate every moment we have together. I can't stay away from you much longer. So for some of you, you may spend some time with this person and they're hoping that you're appreciating those moments with them, because they certainly appreciate them with you. And they can't stay away from you much longer. For some of you, if you're not in contact with this person at all, due to whatever all of these tower energies are representing for you and your person, maybe you're not in contact. They are wanting to come forward. They're thinking about coming forward. Definitely came through on the first card out, that Seven of Pentacles. They're doing something, working toward moving forward. But we did have the Knight of Pentacles, so it may be slow, but they can't stay away much longer. To me, means that they're really kind of, it's heavily on their mind. Whatever these endings are that are happening, that would lead, because endings bring new beginnings, the ending that would lead to this new beginning is heavily on their mind, whether it be your ending or their ending. And for some of you, I feel like it's both. Okay. All right, guys. Well, that is what I have for you for today, crystal number one. I really hope that this reading was helpful. As always, please give it a like and remember to subscribe if you haven't already. Have a wonderful day, and I will see you in the next reading. If you resonated with crystal number two, oops, the citrine crystal, and the blessings or rainbow blessings card, it says blessings are showering your life. Then this will be your reading, okay? Crystal number two. So what I got with that card there was they think they're, you are truly blessed in your life. You're abundant. You're doing very well for yourself. You're making good choices for yourself. And also they feel like you've given them hope for the future. So I feel like you've helped them to think more positively about the future. So that is really, really beautiful energy. This person really does think highly of you. Let's see with crystal number two, please. What are their person's thoughts of them? Now keep in mind, their thoughts could also be about their own life if it affects this connection, or if they're trying to work through something. Page of materials. Ooh, they're looking at you. They're wanting to start something new. They're feeling like they think that a physical relationship with you would be good for both of you. So whatever that means there, they're feeling like you're a good match, maybe. Good for both of you. New start. And that was coming through so fast. New start. So they're thinking about a new start with you. They feel like it's a good match. Like it would be good for both of you. Okay, so they think you're a good pair. You would make a good couple. Ooh. They feel like they've disappointed you. They think they disappointed you in some way. Something to do with, like, passion or something. Physical intimacy? They could be fearing this as well with the Devil card. Yeah, they could be fearing disappointment. Fear of intimacy. So they might be thinking a lot about, because they're very attracted to you. This is very, very passionate energy as well. Sometimes even obsessive, right? With the Devil card. But I feel like it's about fearing the intimacy. They might be thinking that they're going to disappoint you in the intimacy, physical intimacy department. Okay, that might be wounding from their past that they're needing to clear up. Yeah, they're needing to work through. Five of Voices. Yeah, there's some sort of chaos and conflict in their mind. Yeah, they do feel like you're a good match. They feel like you are very, very similar as well. They think about kissing under the mistletoe. That's a specific message for someone. That might be a memory. I feel like that's very specific. A memory maybe from the past. Kissing under the mistletoe. They feel like you're very similar. They think like, wow, crystal number two is just like me. But it almost kind of scares them, or it makes them conflicted in their mind about it. The similarities. It's like looking in a mirror. Mirror. We could be talking about a very powerful soul bond here, and maybe they might not realize this, or they may realize it and it kind of scares them. They might be like, wow, this is different, okay? Because I feel like they think that this connection is different because of that. Like they see so much similarity, good match, right? Like, yeah, they feel like you're one of the same. All right, what else are they thinking? Interesting energy. Yeah, they're fearing the unknown. So for some of you, I feel like you maybe have not been intimate with this person at all, and this is definitely surrounding that fear. They have a lot of things that they want to say, a lot of things that they want to do as well. A lot of thoughts in their mind. There's a lot of fear of the unknown here, though. And fear of intimacy. So they might be afraid that... noticing the three of emotions on the bottom there as well. Yeah, wow. Okay, so their thoughts are a little bit scattered, fearful at this time. I feel like there could even be a fear of, like, they're putting you on a pedestal. They might think you're a great match, but then they get in their head about it and they, like, there's self-doubt, self-limiting beliefs here going on in their mind. This person really doubting themselves. I don't feel like they're doubting you, or at least that hasn't come through yet. I feel like they're doubting themselves. They're a little bit fearful. A few fears coming through here is what I'm feeling. A lot of self-limiting beliefs as well. Yeah, Nine of Wands, wounding. Eight of Pentacles, hard work paying off. So they think that, you know, the hard work that you put into this connection will pay off with the Eight of Wands. I mean, the Eight of Pentacles here, but the Nine of Wands. Wow, I said those backwards. Okay, Nine of Pentacles is the single independent energy. Eight of Wands, talking about communication. I don't believe in coincidences, so I might have said those backwards for a reason. Maybe they're wanting to communicate this to you, that they feel like they're thinking here, right? The hard work will pay off. I want to communicate this to crystal number two, but I'm afraid. Okay, with this wounding coming through. Single independent. So they might see you as single independent, think that you take care of yourself. You, again, it's the same energy that came through in the beginning. They feel like you're doing very well for yourself, that you're abundant, that you take good care of yourself, you make good choices for yourself. They may feel not good enough, but at the same time, they're thinking and feeling like, wow, we're so similar, we would make a great match or a great couple. So I feel like this person has a lot of confusion in their mind about you. Not that they're doubting you, they're doubting themselves. Okay, is what I feel here. So this person in some sort of conflict in the mind, a little bit of overthinking possibly going on here. Four of Emotions and the Devil. Crystal number two's person's thoughts of them, please. Four of Emotions and the Devil card, please. Definitely picking up for some of you. You might not have been intimate with this person. And yeah, they're afraid to break your heart. They're afraid that they're not going to live up to what you desire. There's a lot of fear. They're thinking about a lot of fearful thoughts right here. Seeing this broken heart on the floor, it's kind of like in pieces. They're afraid they're going to disappoint you. And first, with it coming out here, I feel like it's about physical intimacy. But there are other fears as well. So it could be about those as well. They're thinking they need to balance out these thoughts. They're probably right. They need to kind of heal the wounds here that is making them overthink or feel not good enough. Because here with the Five of Voices, they're seeing them similarities. It may even be scaring them, but they're seeing how similar you are. And for someone, remembering a time with a kiss under the mistletoe. So this is them really thinking good, powerful, beautiful memories about you. Justice. Yeah, good, powerful memories about you, loving memories for some of you. But then the fear creeps in to their thoughts and kind of takes over. I feel like this would be this is kind of like a stuck or stagnant situation that we're talking about here. They look up to you, they see you as this beautiful, perfect match for them. They want a new start, but they're kind of blocking themselves with all this fear in their mind. And justice coming out here, there could be some sort of legal matter that someone is dealing with as well. And it might not be for all of you, but for some of you, this could be causing chaos and conflict in their mind as well. It's possible that this person may need to get a divorce, right? Or you need to get a divorce. You know, this could be them thinking about you. Maybe you're married and maybe they feel like they could never live up to your current situation. If you're, let's say, married or in a, you know, this doesn't have to be marriage either. This could be a committed relationship where two parties have to maybe take this to the justice system to come up with some sort of a fair and equitable division upon, you know, releasing the commitment to one another. So this could be something that's really heavily on their mind as well. Whether it be for them or for you, it could be something that's very heavily on their mind. The moon. What are these fears? I wonder if they're the same. Nope. Yeah. Oh, right. Okay. Yep. For some of you, it is about passion, desire, physical intimacy, wanting closeness, but fearing it. But for others of you, it's, again, King of Wands is a very confident energy. So I feel like it coming out on the moon is saying that they have a lack of confidence in themselves, okay? So they think they're not good enough, okay? They think that even though they see you as a perfect match, similar, a good couple, that maybe you don't feel that way about them. And those are all self-limiting beliefs. That is not necessarily the case. You may feel like this person is your perfect match, okay? What I'm noticing here, Four of Wands brought to my attention. Yeah, they want commitment. They think about commitment with you. This person really feels like you'd be a good match. I'm going to put that with the Page of Pentacles, because a Page of Materials, same thing. Because I feel like with the Four of Wands showing up there, look at that, 11-11, could be a twin flame as well with this 11-11. Four of Wands is also, could indicate a twin flame connection. But this person wanting commitment, feeling like you're the right match for them, but at the same time, fearing that you don't feel the same way, or that you don't see them the way that you see them, possibly, okay? I mean, maybe some of you do see them as not good enough for you, or, you know, maybe that is the case. However, this is what's in their thoughts, but that might not be the case. Maybe you don't think that way at all, but this person is fearing all of those things, okay? And that's kind of what's, I feel for a lot of you, this is kind of a stuck or stagnant situation where it's kind of slow moving or non-moving, possibly even no contact, but wanting, because I know I said Eight of Pentacles, there is a wanting to communicate, because I said Eight of Wands earlier, and I don't believe in coincidences, so I feel like they do think about communicating this to you. But then their wounding prevents them. Okay? Wow. All right. Lots going on here. Let's see what else for crystal number two. We have two out here. Look at these two kitties as well. They're pretty similar as well. Not exact, but similar. I think so. Warrior and curiosity. Wow, yeah, they see you as strong, a fighter, someone who, you know, again, takes really good care of yourself. You got this, you know, it's like you don't need anyone. You are self-sufficient, okay, and curious. They're very curious about you. So they have a lot of thoughts about who you are on a deeper level, okay? They're very curious about that. That is in their thoughts as well. Crystal number two. What are their person's thoughts of them, please? Crystal number two's person's thoughts of them. What are crystal number two's person's thoughts of them, please? And remember, energy does shift and change, okay, very quickly. This is their thoughts right now, but, you know, next week or tomorrow, that could be different, okay? So, is this more than one? No. Okay, we have two here. This one here. Only time will tell. So they may feel like in time, they'll get the answers they need. They'll do the healing they need to do to be able to stand up and speak their truth, okay? Really speak these thoughts. Very nice. Healing. Imagine yourself and your beloved surrounded by light. Feel your relationship being healed this very moment. Yeah, your energy is very healing to this connection, okay? Your energy is very powerful. This person, again, feels like you are like a keeper, you know? You are like top of the line relationship material, right? Wanting marriage, commitment, someone that they can see long term with. But fear is, for this crystal here, fear is in this person's mind pretty heavily. We had the Devil, the Five of Voices, and the Moon, kind of like back to back as well. So a lot. Speak your world into being. See, yeah. So they see that you speak up for yourself. You do the right thing by yourself. You choose yourself, right? This person wanting to do the same, okay? Really thinking about how they can get themselves to that point. So with the healing card coming out, that's a good sign that this person is really thinking heavily about getting through this wounding and moving forward. So that's good. What else do they think about crystal number two? Yeah, wow. This connection is special. They think it's very special. For some of you, I definitely feel like they see this. They realize something here, okay, with the similarities and, you know, that just feeling that deep connection. And for some of you, it is a little bit scary for this person. But they think this connection is magical. It's special. It's one of a kind. Aw, love. I don't know if you can see it. It's right near the speak. Beautiful. Yeah, they love you. So they do think loving thoughts about you. They do feel that love within as well. Beautiful. What else for crystal number two? That was fast. Oh, and there's like multiple too. There's like three. Ooh. Very good. Okay. Sorry, got all excited there. Three good cards right here. Communication. Okay, definitely. It came through on that misstep on my words, so I do feel like they think about this a lot, okay? And they are thinking about healing, so this is good. They're thinking that they need to go inward and heal these thoughts that they're having, okay? And shift into positivity. So this is beautiful that all these came through, okay? Absolutely beautiful. Good sign that if they think these beautiful, wonderful things about you, if they could heal themselves and kind of squash those fears, right? Really work through them, heal themselves and move beyond, it could be a beautiful connection. Long term, there's love, there's magic. I mean, King of Wands, you know, needing to be more confident. Because again, you know, I don't really read. Like if it falls like this, if I feel it's that way, I'll read it that way. But this one was definitely a lack of confidence coming out on that moon. And usually the other way around, it's someone who's very confident. I feel like this person is not confident in themselves. Yeah, breathe. So they're needing to, I feel like they think about this a lot as well. I need to meditate. They're trying to put a spiritual practice in place to get their thoughts more positive on a regular basis, okay? Because they feel and they think that that will help to improve this connection, okay? Which I absolutely feel like that would improve this connection. Because again, there are a lot of feelings. They really admire you. They look up to you. They have deep respect for you and love. Whoa. Yeah, there it is, right? Not saying what they're feeling, hiding what they feel out of fear, okay? this is all over the place here. They're fearing a lot. They might be fearing that you're not going to choose them. They fear intimacy. There's a lot of self-limiting beliefs coming through in the Five of Voices today. And yeah, they're deceiving themselves with those thoughts. Those thoughts are keeping them stuck. Stuck in place. Wherever that may be. For, you know, everyone here has a different situation. And always remember, not all messages will resonate for everyone. But this is keeping this person stuck. Whether it be alone, whether it be in another relationship, whether it be with their family who doesn't support them and love them the way they need, whatever it may be, it's whatever these thoughts are here, all of these self-limiting beliefs is really keeping this person stuck. But there are good signs here. So absolutely, with the positivity, the healing, breathe. They're really thinking about this heavily, that this is something that they need to focus on. So that is a good thing. Right, two more, and then we're going to get some message cards as well. Relationship patterns. It takes strength to recognize the need for change. See? So maybe this is something that they do all the time. Maybe they find someone that they really love and then they sabotage themselves, okay, in relationships because of their thoughts. They may also think that, for some of you, they may also think that you sabotage your relationships as well. For some of you, you might be self-sabotaging, not necessarily this connection, but maybe some in the past. Or this one. Okay, multiple things coming through. So for some of you, you may even be self-sabotaging this connection as well. Now that's a double-edged ouchie, I guess. If you're self-sabotaging and they're self-sabotaging, both of you in need of healing. So that is a possibility as well. Okay, let's get more for crystal number two. Their person's thoughts of them, please. Taking action. So they are, again, we had this here, the hard work paying off, this wanting this new beginning in the physical world. Page of Pentacles is, or Page of Materials in that deck, is about taking action in the physical world. Okay, we have Wands energy out here, but this is wounded. Nine of Wands. Okay, wounded. So, but they are thinking about taking action, okay? They just have to get through some stuff, some mind chatter, okay? In order to get there, they're going to need to get through that mind stuff. Okay, let's get some message cards. Crystal number two's person's thoughts of them, please. What would they like to say? Or their thoughts of them? Crystal number two's person, please. There we go. I miss you so much it hurts. Yeah, so for you stagnant, slow, no contact situations, for those of you that are resonating with that here, this person is missing you very much. So you're heavily on their mind. They do think about you very heavily here, I feel. This is very much on their mind. Let's see what else. Their thoughts of crystal number two. I feel like they have great thoughts about you, crystal number two. They just don't have great thoughts about themselves. And it's kind of blocking the manifestation from happening, the connection from coming together. But again, that's them. They have to take care of... Oh my, wow. Wow. Another card about missing you, wow. Yeah, I feel like for some of you, this is really breaking someone's heart that they're not with you. I miss you more than you know. And I got this deep sadness come over me with that card hit the table, and both of them are about missing you. There's also an infinity symbol, a number eight infinity symbol there. A number eight on its side. Let's see what else. You hold the key to my heart. Very nice. Yeah, so feeling like you are the one for them. They feel that deep, powerful connection and similarity with you. They feel like they're looking in a mirror right? They feel that. This is deep. This is a powerful connection that this person is feeling with you here. And it's very heavily on their mind. What else would crystal number two's person want to say? I can't stay away from you much longer. So wanting to come back into your life if they have exited your life. For some of you, or maybe even for a lot of you, I feel like this person, it has exited your life in some way. So they do think about coming back to you, and they feel like they can't stay away much longer. So yeah, if you are separated from this person or not with this person at this time, they do want you to be happy regardless. They think that you know, they don't blame you if you've moved on. I feel like they don't want you to, but that's up to you, right? And that's up to how you feel about this connection. But this person just wants you to be happy is what I'm really feeling there with that card. They just want you to be happy. They don't blame you if you've moved on. They understand. What else? You are my everything. Wow. Okay. I'll put those back later. You are my everything. So yeah, you are very important. You're very heavily on this person's mind, crystal number two. A lot going on in the mind though. A lot of overthinking, but I feel like there's hope here for sure with this person taking action toward working on themselves and getting those thoughts into balance. All right, crystal number two. Well, that is what I have for you for today. I really hope that this reading was helpful. Please give it a like and remember to subscribe if you haven't already. Have a wonderful day, and I will see you in the next reading. If you resonated with crystal number three, the Tiger's Eye crystal, and the Surrendering to the Journey card, this will be your reading, okay, crystal number three. So immediately it says release control, surrendering to the journey. So what I got here was that your person is hoping and, you know, feeling like they hope that you trust them and how they feel for you. They think you are their guiding light. And they hope that you're trusting in the universe as well. So I feel like this person thinks that you are their person. And that the love that they emanate from their energy toward you, like the energy that they show you or give you, makes you realize that deep within. So they're hoping that you're trusting in that, okay? They may also be thinking about communicating, getting that now. This little owl in the tree up here is really standing out to me there. So they may be thinking about communicating something to you as well with that coming through, okay? Let's see what the tarot has to say for crystal number three. What is their person's thoughts of them? I definitely feel like this person thinks you are very special to them, and they show you this through their energy is what I'm feeling here. And I'll apologize up front in this reading as well. I'm trying to do it in a couple readings so people will know. If you do hear a hum come on in the background, it is my air conditioner, and it's so hot in the studio that it is absolutely necessary. So I'm pretty sure you can hear me pretty well. Anyway, so please ignore any background humming that you may hear. Ten of inspiration, because I don't want to melt. I want to read for you guys. So they feel like they're a burden to you at times. They might be thinking they're burdening you with something. We're going to find out more about that one with the clarifier, but they feel like they're burdening you with something here. Like it's in their mind, right? They're thinking like whatever this is a burden to crystal number three, and it has to do with them. They feel like they are burdening you. So they think they're burdening you with something. Let's see their thoughts. Ooh, they're super passionate about you. Yeah, they're wanting to come forward. So they're thinking about coming forward with passion. Could be that communication might be that as well. Could be some flirty messages going on here. They could be thinking about that. they could actually be thinking about getting together physically, okay? Some physical intimacy on their mind here. And they're very passionate about you. They're very attracted to you. They think you're extremely attractive. Let's see. What else? Crystal number three's person's thoughts of them. Crystal number three's person's thoughts of them, please. Now keep in mind, it may be their thoughts of you. It may be thoughts about their situation. Wow. Yeah. They think you're their person. They want to marry you. They think about marriage and commitment, long-term stability here with you. Wow. Yeah, I was definitely picking that up with that first card out. This person sees you as the one for them. They think you are it. You are the one. Well, let's see, what else do they think of crystal number three? So yeah, their thoughts could come through because, you know, they are not just having one thought process throughout the day. So their thoughts coming through could be about, you know, their life, things that they may need to change in order to make this situation come together. I'm kind of feeling what this is about here. So that's why I'm kind of saying that here as well, because I'm already feeling like there's something in their life that is heavily on their mind that they feel like they're burdening you with. Can I get one more, please, for crystal number three's person's thoughts of them? They could be thinking they're too slow for your liking here. Ooh, and they're in love, too. Nice. Okay. So, they are in love with you, Ace of Emotions. They're wanting a new start in love, but they also have a lot of conflict surrounding their thoughts about it. So there are some conflicting thoughts here surrounding a new start. We're going to find out what these are. Yeah, we'll do this here together because I feel like those two are together. It's the conflicting thoughts that they're having in their mind is in regards to this new start. So something in their mind, something that they're thinking about that could be preventing this right here. This is what I'm feeling. Okay, let's see for crystal number three, why the Ten of Inspiration? What is that person's thoughts of them? Time, temperance, having to be patient, and Knight of Wands, unable to move forward. So unable to move forward, but wanting to here. Maybe they, for some of you, now keep in mind, these are general readings, so it might not be relevant for all of you, but for some of you, this person may have moved forward at one point in time, and they felt like that was burdening you because you're still having to wait. Like there's temperance here, that you have to be patient with this situation. Maybe they rushed in too quickly when they weren't ready, and they feel like that's a burden to you. I feel like there's one more coming through here, so I'm going to shuffle again. This is for some of you. I feel like they've rushed in when they weren't ready. Maybe they backed off, and they're feeling like they're burdening you because you're having to wait still, and you might be... They might be thinking that you thought that they were a player. Does that make sense? they might be thinking that you are viewing them as a player, and they feel like that was a burden, okay? Might not be the case. I definitely don't think that's the case with these cards coming out. But for some of you, maybe that is what you thought. But let's see. I need one more on the Ten of Inspiration, please, for crystal number three. There is. Yeah, this is about competition. I knew it. There's other people involved. I knew it. Five of Wands. Yeah, that's kind of what I was feeling here. There's other people involved. It's causing slowness. and they may have rushed in. This could all be the same person too. This could all be the same situation. There's other people involved. They may have rushed in, but they're not ready because someone, you or them, are dealing with something to do with other people. And there's still a need for patience here. So they feel like that was a burden because they, for some of you, rushed toward you, okay? When they weren't ready to take that next step. Knight of Inspiration, but they're wanting to here. Yeah, nine of, look at that. Wish fulfillment does not want to fall. See, it's so sticky in here. That's why the air conditioner, too, helps my cards to actually work, too. When it's humid, they are so sticky. Some decks, not all of them, but this one's one of the ones likes to stick. Nine of Cups. Yeah, you are their wish fulfillment. They think you're the one. They do want to rush forward toward you because you make their wishes come true. So they are thinking about doing this, but I feel with this coming out here, it may take some time. Okay, and I know you probably don't want to hear that, but that's why surrendering is there. Trust me. I hope that they can trust me, right? Trust the universe. Trust me. Trust what I feel. Trust what they feel. Yeah, this is, I feel like this is a situation for you guys, crystal number three, where there just isn't a readiness, and it has to do for some of you with other people surrounding the situation. Look at this magician. Yeah, so this is nice. So they are thinking about manifesting this connection into their life. They could even be thinking about manifesting a proposal of some sort, okay, with this coming out on the Four of Inspiration. Okay, so when they do come forward, it could be a big coming forward is what I'm getting here. Okay, big. Marriage on the mind, commitment on the mind, stability on their mind. Okay, wish fulfillment. True, passionate love, okay? This is absolutely heart fulfilled, overflowing with love for you. And the conflict here is what I'm curious about here, this Five of Voices. What is this about for crystal number three? Their thoughts of crystal number three. Ace of Emotions, Five of Voices. What is that? Eight of... Yeah, if someone's feeling bound to something else, they're trying to break free. The Eight of Swords. Okay. Mental prison. Someone could be overthinking for some of you as well. Could be overthinking this new start, okay? For others, I'm feeling like they're stuck. They're feeling stuck in some sort of situation that they're trying to break free from, okay? So this is heavily on their mind because they know that something here, right, needs to be resolved before this can happen. So it's heavily on their mind. I feel like they're thinking a lot about the future. 11:11 just crossed my timer. And the Four of Inspiration is also a sign of twin flames as well. So this could be your twin flame we're talking about. Might not be. Of course, not everyone here is on the twin flame journey necessarily that's watching. But this doesn't mean that the energy doesn't apply to you. If that doesn't apply to you, just leave it behind. Move on. It applies to someone else, I assure you. There's plenty of twin flames here on this channel. Peace and wild. Wow. Okay. Wow. Yeah. Hoo-wee. This person. Wow. This is powerful. You bring them a sense of peace that they've never felt in their life. And wild, they're extremely, there's an intense passion between you. And it's on their mind. They could even be having fantasies about physical intimacy with you here. It was coming through here as well. But fantasies possibly with that wild card. Okay, they could be, you could be heavily on their mind. Maybe even dreams, you know, daydreams, night dreams. Mm-hmm, heavily on their mind. Very attracted, very, very attracted, and in love too with that Ace of Emotions. Yeah, seeing from a different perspective. So they think that you see things from a different perspective, which is good. You see beyond, which is good. You're not just looking at what's happening in front of you. in the 3D. You're looking at the deeper meaning with this eye here on the tree. Okay. Time. You are trying too hard. Give it time. Okay. That's why surrender is out. So for some of you, release control. Trust them. Trust the universe. They think, even they feel like maybe you're trying too hard to push this forward. Just relax through it. Trust in them. Trust in what you feel. You are their guiding light. They think that right from the beginning of this reading. You are the guiding light. You are the inspiration. Okay, so just relax through it. They might feel like you're trying to control the situation a little bit, and that's okay. We all do it. You're human. It's okay. Don't beat yourself up for it. Okay? Don't do that. Just try your best to try to release control of the situation, relax, and just have faith and trust in the universe, especially because the universe has your back. And this is a powerful connection here. Very beautiful love with that Ace of Emotions. Okay, let's get more for crystal number 3, their person's thoughts of them. Okay, we have Aquarius. Okay, Aquarius, first thing coming through. Open up to change. Okay, so they know and they think about all the changes that are going to have to take place. It's on their mind. They're thinking about this. So they are aware that there are changes that need to be made. This could be in your life or their life. Either way, it's surrounding, for some of you, other people, other situations, things that they were feeling stuck in, possibly overthinking. Even if it's just overthinking, that still kind of needs to change, because overthinking is a low vibrational energy and it's going to block that love connection from coming in. Okay, let's get more for crystal number 3, their person's thoughts of them. Sorry, I was trying to adjust my mic again. Yeah, there's that. See, they do think that you see beyond. You are a genius too. You are very intuitive, a very powerful being. They think very highly of you and they see how powerful you are. And I feel like they think here that you, again, it came through right here with this eye. You see things. You see through the matrix, you know, you look beyond. They have hope in this. They have hope in this connection because they feel and think that you are really tapped into the universe and that you are capable of seeing the deeper meaning, feeling rather than thinking. So even if this is you and overthinking, which I think it's them possibly, but it could be you, they know that you'll overcome it because you're powerful and you know it. Deep within, you know that you have this inner strength. What else do they think? Ooh, look at, see, new beginning. So a new beginning is on their mind. This person is really thinking about this new start. This is a relationship starting. Ace of Emotions, being in love. They are thinking about this new beginning. And for some of you, it's a big new beginning. Okay, this is manifesting, I feel like, a big, coming out on that Four of Inspiration like a proposal. Okay, it's a big start that this is on this person's mind. And that might not be for everyone. That might be just for some of you. But definitely feel like that is a possibility for some of you here as well. Okay, let's get more. What is crystal number 3's person's thoughts of them? Crystal number 3's person's thoughts of them. Tr- trust. There it is again. Yeah, ooh, and recognition. Mm-hmm. Trust and recognition. Trust in that inner knowing, okay? Again, that same message from the beginning of the reading. It's coming through again, so I feel like it's a very powerful message to trust them. Trust that recognition that you felt. Trust what you feel in your heart. Trust yourself. Trust your decisions. Trust what you know within, right? What you know. Not your thoughts. Your inner feeling, your knowing, your that deep intuition that you have. Trust in that about this situation. There could have been moments of overthinking where maybe the thoughts came out of someone's mouth here, okay? And it made this person feel like you didn't trust in what you were feeling for them, or you didn't trust in what they feel for you. Something like that here coming through, because I feel with multiple messages as well. And that Eight of Voices over here, this Eight of Swords, which is the Eight of Voices in this deck, but whatever. Eight of Swords energy there is definitely talking about those thoughts being voiced at some point in the past, okay? And maybe it caused this person to feel like they, oh, look at, yeah, another card of new start. Yeah, kind of made this person feel like you didn't trust in what you were feeling, or you didn't trust in what how they felt for you. Come to the edge. So yeah, there's another energy of new beginnings. This is like the Fool energy for me in this deck. Taking that risk, taking that leap of faith. I'm going to put it right here with that one, because I feel like this is very heavily on this person's mind. They're wanting to manifest this. They're wanting to rush forward toward you. And again, there's something here that might slow things down, but this is all in their thought process. Okay? And that might, even this something slowing it down, this might not be relevant to you. If this isn't relevant to you, great, you're on your road to, well, then we have the overthinking, but maybe that's not relevant to you either. So you always have to take what fits for you and leave the rest. Door to personal healing and happiness. Yeah, you're the one, you're the guiding light. You are the door, okay? They think that you are their happiness. You are what has helped them to heal. You've given them hope. Yeah, this is beautiful. They really, really, this person really deeply loves you. You make them extremely happy. Absolutely beautiful energy there as well. You make them very happy. I keep getting stuck on my wires today. It's the humidity, but the air conditioner is helping for sure. I don't know why I'm having such an issue over here. Anyway, what do we got? What else for crystal number three, please? Their thoughts of you. Your person's thoughts of you. Crystal number three. Ooh, wow. Ooh-wee, yes. This is, I'm telling you, for some of you, this person just wants to be with you. This is, I feel on their mind so much. It is so prevalent in their thoughts. This person wants union, wanting to come together. This is another possible twin flame connection here. This coming through on this card. For this deck, this card to me does represent a twin flame union, okay? But it doesn't have to be a twin flame, okay? Like I said, with all of these cards, it doesn't have to be. It could just be someone here who really, truly, deeply loves you at the soul level. This is a very powerful connection that they're feeling to you, and they want to be with you. They want to come together. They think about this a lot, okay? So very, very heavily in your person's thoughts, crystal number three. Lots of beautiful, beautiful thoughts for you here as well. Let's see what else for crystal number three. They have attraction and devoted. Wow. Attraction and devoted. Yeah, they're devoted at the heart for you. You hold the key here. I wouldn't be surprised. I'm getting you message cards next. I wouldn't be surprised if that card flew out. Because you hold the key to my heart just coming through here. So that message card coming through right here in this devoted card. Beautiful. Yeah, you are the one for them. And they're very attracted. As I've already stated in this reading, they are very, very attracted to you physically. Okay, and to your inner beauty as well. They see that beauty within. Absolutely beautiful. Okay, let's get some message cards for crystal number three. What would crystal number three's person want to say to them? Or what are their thoughts? Either way, oops. Sorry, messing everything up here. Ooh, I still have healing to do. Yeah, so there is something. This could be for them as well, right? Like I said, it could be you or them. Healing some, you know, fearful thoughts, overthinking. Overthinking is probably surrounded by a bunch of fear. So healing, okay? This could be what's taking time, or it could be whatever situation this is here as well with other people, right? What else would crystal number three's person want to say, or what are their thoughts about them? What else? I am so afraid you will stop loving me. So there's a fear, okay? So for some of you, your person is afraid that if it takes time, you're going to stop loving them. Card 22 coming through there. Please forgive me. Yeah, so again, there was something here, right, that I felt. They felt like they burdened you in some way. For some of you, they rushed in and then pulled away, and you're like, what is going on? There was a lot of confusion. They feel like they hurt you and that they burdened you, so they want you to forgive them here. They're asking for your forgiveness. Oh, absolutely. Peace came through already, and happiness. Yeah, you make them very happy, and peace came through earlier. So you definitely make this person feel amazing. You bring them so much peace, so much happiness. Crystal number three's person's thoughts of them, or what they would like to say. Their thoughts or what they would like to say to crystal number three. We will be together soon, my love. So yeah, they're definitely thinking about coming forward soon. For some of you, it again may be slow, but maybe not for some of you as well, right? General reading, so take it as it resonates for you. What is your intuition telling you? Are they on their way, or are they still working on stuff? You should know, right? Within, you are your best guide. You are my soulmate. Yeah, so they feel that deep, powerful connection to you. They feel it in the soul, you know. They know that this is different. They know that this is special. They know that you're their person. And they are devoted to you at the heart space. And of course, that's if your intuition tells you that they're devoted to you. Remember that, right, about these readings? These are meant to confirm what your intuition is already telling you. Okay, if your intuition is telling you that they're not devoted to you, don't let this reading tell you that, because that's not resonating with your intuition. So only take what resonates for you. All right, crystal number three. Well, I really hope that this reading was helpful. This is what I have for you for today. As always, please give it a like and remember to subscribe if you haven't already. I greatly appreciate it. I appreciate you all being here as well. Have a wonderful day. And I will see you in the next reading.